Hello, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Rob, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you a quick and painless method to obtain root access using Kitsune Mask, also known as Magisk Delta, on the latest version of BlueStacks. This is the 2024 edition, and I'm thrilled to demonstrate that this method works seamlessly, whether your PC is cluttered or a fresh build. It's important to note that this guide is specifically for non-Hyper-V installations. While I haven't developed the guide for Hyper-V yet, the steps are similar, and you might find helpful resources on platforms like XDA or GitHub. Additionally, I want to address the recent trend of one-click scripts that claim to do the same job. I'm a bit old school. As stated on my page, no external scripts or tools are necessary for this process. Right now, you can see I am showing you my Redmo hosted on my GitHub page. Check out the description below for links to more information and resources. All right, let's dive in. First, we'll download the Kitsune Mask AKO Magisk Delta APK file. The stable version should do the trick. Next, head over to the links below and download BlueStacks 5. If you're a bit cautious, feel free to search Google for an alternative download link. Proceed with the BlueStacks installation by accepting the default values. I'll make sure the default installation location matches the one I'll reference throughout this guide. If you follow the steps as I describe, you shouldn't encounter any problems. By default, the installation includes three applications: BlueStacks-XGA, a cloud-based emulator; BlueStacks Services; and the BlueStacks App Player. During installation, I recommend uninstalling the two formers as soon as they appear. These are just unneeded bloatware. I sort the list of installed programs by date installed, so when I hit refresh, it should appear in the list. Uninstall them both, but leave the app player. After installation finishes, a Pi64 instance will automatically start. From here, you can get to the multi-instance manager via the toolbar on the right, or just search it from the Windows Start menu. Either way, stop the Pi64 instance once the manager opens. In the multi-instance manager, create a new Android 11 master instance. You will need to set up a few things. Follow along with my choices, or if you have some of your own, do it. Do not run the instance after it downloads. There's no need, and it would just be a waste of time. However, once the download is done, close the multi-instance manager, and let's get down to rooting this thing. Navigate to the /program/data/BlueStacks/next directory to find the BlueStacks.conf file. If you don't see the program data folder on your C drive, you'll need to enable the option to show hidden files in your OS settings. Right-click on the BlueStacks.conf file, and you'll have the option to edit it with Notepad, or if installed, Notepad++. I'll be using the latter. Here, you'll need to change two settings. You can do this manually, or via the Replace All function in Notepad. Change best.feature.routing0 to best.feature.routing1. Change bs.instance.rvc. 64.enable_root_access =0 to bbs.instance.rvc 64.enable_root_access =1. Save your changes and then head to the C/program/data/BlueStacks/xt-engine-rvc64-cell directory. You must edit two different files: android.bstk.in and rvc64.bstk. In each of the files, there are two values for two different keys that must be changed: fastboot.bdi and root.bhd. So, at the top, you should see those two keys, or you could use the replace all function again. Either way, make sure you change the values in both files from read-only to normal. save your changes, and open the Multi-Instance Manager. Start up the Android 11 instance. Drag the downloaded Kitsune Mask APK file we downloaded earlier onto the emulator, or use the Install APK option from the sidebar to sideload it. Once Magisk is open, click on Install at the top right. In the new pane that follows, click Next on the right and select the bottom radio button for Direct Install to System Partition, followed by Let's Go on the right. If successful, you'll see the success confirmation log. If it fails, or you do not see the option to install directly to the system partition, close the Kitsune Android app, reopen it, and try again. This time, it will be there. Afterwards, close the instance, because we have one more thing to do. Head back to the BlueStacks.conf file and change the settings we set earlier. Specifically, change bysd.instance.rvc64.enable_root_access=1 back to 0. I will show you how to confirm this worked by running the instance again, and you will see the superuser and modules, as well as the setting for root, are enabled. Happy hacking! If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to subscribe, then visit my GitHub and give me a star.